And also gave us some freestyle. Today we are also going to meet another wonderful star. I told you, here in Ekpe land, most especially Ahoda East local government, we got stars, artists that knows the lyrics, that have tunes, that have the vibes to move the crowd. So today we are also going to meet another wonderful star here in Ahoda East local government.
I know. Oh yeah, you dey blow my mind, blow my mind, blow my mind. For your love, I go change my life, change my life, change my life. Yeah, but come here to your dance, make us play Lego. Dirty wine for me, I say so.
You're welcome once again, and yeah, finally, the star I've been talking about. Please meet with me, Drizzy Wizzy. Drizzy Wizzy, what's up, bro? How have you been doing? After the COVID-19 paro with you, I believe it's somehow affecting your music.
Yeah, definitely affecting every corner of my life because I'm not being able to meet up with you because I work with people who are being affected by COVID. So, I don't know if I'm going
to be okay. So, on your own now, what have you been up to since you've been closed doors? Have you been running on new materials for music and products? So do we, are we expecting anything new for our label?
Definitely, because a lot of my fans like me to drop some of the products and go to my music and try it out. I tried to come and do it and buy it.
Sure, he's from Ahoda.
Definitely, why not? He's from Ahoda. But he's just from the western part of Ahoda.
The western part of Ahoda. He's your brother.
Definitely, why not?
Wow. That's good. Okay, I want to know your name. I know that your pet given name is not Drizzy Wizzy.
Yeah.
So, what's your actual name?
Actually, people do feel like people normally call me Wizzy, Drizzy Wizzy. Because of writing my mom, my dad, everybody.
So how come about the Drizzy Wizzy name, the stage name Drizzy Wizzy?
Actually, my name Drizzy Wizzy. When I started music, I love vines. Seems very much. I love vines. Like, when I'm singing, I have to do vines all the time. I love singing. So I was like, I don't know if I need to do it.
We already have a whiskey, we already have this and whiz that. So how long have you been doing this?
This is only 2015.
2015?
2014.
4 years. Okay. So have I believe you must have performed on the stage before. So many times, have you? Mm-hmm. So you're even tired of the stage. Now you're looking forward to facing the cameras.
Yeah, that's good.
So the first time you went on stage, what did you feel? How did you feel? What you felt that day?
In actuality, you say that particular day, I was afraid. Instead of like my mind,
tension was like,
what if I sing now and people don't like my song? Yeah, it would be like boo, boo, all these kind of things. Like, because I was scared because of when people didn't, people do not know me, like who I am, like I sing. But just one or two people that listen to my song, but then I know being exposed of getting your song in the studio, put it online for people and download. Even if the thing was just when I'm done my song, I put it on my phone, I sell it to YouTube, So definitely two or three people that have heard my show that have listened to the show, like, I would say like, and when I came out there, there's a lot of stars there. Like, I don't even feel like I had a chance to.
Meaning intimidation started coming.
Yeah, like, I wouldn't be out like, for people to listen to me. So I was really trying. I never wanted to give up. I was trying. So yeah, I fed up and I was prepared, like, so as I was going, so definitely a guy that knew me very well, that I listened to my song, the guy loved my song so very much, like, yeah, you
can encourage to be
there, like, what is for you, and all that. The influence of me coming from town, and this guy was town people, so like, this kind of thing. So they used to be like, they carried me.
Wow.
Passed through the crowd.
Wow.
And they told the MC, I want this person. And now.
So they had to intro you in person.
Yeah. Wow. And now. So when the MC said, okay, no problem, this is your name, freshman, the teacher, my CD, I gave him my CD, and they paid me, and they called me. And then I started rapping. Like, I played rap, and for my language, which is Arabic. So I would like to use. And I started like,
you had to do something to praise and make the fans connect.
I'm the star of the video, like, hey, it's your boy, Jesus, Mahuta, aka Malema, like, Kalashini, whatever language.
I tell you.
And the job, passenger, we're not done, we're not going to spend down, we're not going to lend time.
Like, bro, you're already a rapper, you're ready.
So, when I was doing this, like, hey, the club like, everyone was shouting, like, it's not. So when they played the song, man, and I dropped the song, and sang it again, I sang it for the third time, and before I left the stage, I left with almost 2,600 naira, and I spent 10,000 naira on that.
Instantly,
yeah, on that song.
On that song, okay, yeah. You made out a profit of like
6,600 naira.
Wow.
No, 8,600 naira. So that encouraged me and pushed me to write the next song, which I'll be featuring the paper to go in my teacher class. Because it was close to me and he loved the energy and how I was doing my thing. So I accepted him to that song today. So from there, after that particular day, that performance I did, we started talking about me.
Small boy from the hood,
yeah, what's that? You have all these
things.
So,
okay, so far so good now. I would love to ask also, do you have any sponsor or manager?
Actually, I have a manager.
Okay,
I don't have any sponsor. What I've been a sponsor of, I don't even depend on you.
Okay,
because I need my career.
Okay. So, and your manager also do the producing of your music, or you have a producer that stands behind you that whenever you want to voice out something nice, you call him, do it like this, like this.
Yeah, definitely. Actually, I started with the original record.
Okay.
Then I started with the original record. This is actually the original record. Classic.
freestyling, like we're doing freestyling, checking out the music, and that was how it put me. X-Lex, Pico Trace, and me. So, we found out like, fast rise, not school, after the school, he was good to me. He was helping me to, like, anytime I follow him, he was about to like, listen to me, job, go work, and see what I'm doing. So, that was good. So, to be, maybe, you know, even right now, they're doing the business for everything.
Indirectly, he's trying to promote you also.
Okay. See, if you still want to get more of this vibe and this coverage we're doing, you can just log on to www.lookupcontentblog.com for you to see more of Drizzy Weezy and other artists that we have also gone through. So, Drizzy Weezy, I want to ask this question because I know inside of you, you feel you should be that way. Where do you see yourself in the next 5 years? Apart from the fact that we are passing this COVID-19 issue, like, where do you see yourself in the music industry?
My brother, in 7 years, there is still possibly that hard in myself. I know what I carry on was inside of me. Music carry, like, looking for me to do the show. You know, sometimes I used to worry when I'm looking at the top, like, I'm looking at the top. I see women, I see five girls, I see two guys, I see this guy, like, all these guys. I feel angry sometimes because I'm supposed to be there doing something again. But my friend always tells me that it is not easy. It's not easy. For me, I believe in it. For me, it's time to come say, to leave nobody to do that. So from that day, that was to be that. Okay, to be like that. Like, motivated me, and I believe that's going to be.